Mountain View, California, NY Times, in 2007, Anne Wojcicki, then 33, lassoed the moon. She was getting her new company, 23andMe, a mail-order genetics testing firm, off the ground with her Party Till You Spit celebrity get-togethers. She married Sergey Brin, the cute co-founder of Google, who was also 33 and already one of the richest men in America, at a top-secret Esther Williams extravaganza in the Bahamas. The bride in a white bathing suit and the groom in a black one, they swam to a sandbar in the Bahamas and got hitched in the middle of the sparkling aquamarine ocean. Soon after the marriage, as Brin accumulated more power, a yacht and a fleet of jets, Wojcicki became pregnant with the first of their two children, and Google invested millions in her startup, named after the 23 paired chromosomes that consist of our DNA. But 6 years later, the Silicon Valley fairy tale was shattered by two public humiliations. Brin got involved with a beautiful young Englishwoman named Amanda Rosenberg, who provided a public face for Google Glass, an attachment that broke up his marriage. And the Food and Drug Administration shut down the primary function of Wojcicki's business, calling her DNA spit vial an unapproved medical device and imposing stricter rules for consumer genetic testing. Her business, once so ripe with promise to tackle health issues, was curtailed to its ancestry testing division. And here is where genetics saved the genetics entrepreneur. Her father, Stanley, fled Poland in 1949 when he was 12 with his mother when the communists took over. Her mother, Esther, was the daughter of impoverished Orthodox Russian Jews who immigrated to New York in the 1920s. The Wojcickis grew into Silicon Valley royalty. It's the sort of family, and jokes, where you're only a viable fetus once you have your PhD. Stanley is the former chairman of the Stanford Physics Department and an emeritus professor. Esther is a journalism teacher so beloved at Palo Alto High School that her former student James Franco made a video paean to her. Besides Anne, there are two older daughters, Susan, who was Google employee No. 18 and is now the CEO of YouTube, and Janet, an epidemiologist, medical anthropologist, associate professor at the University of California San Francisco School of Medicine and a Fulbright scholar. My mom is utterly the believer, like she can get anything done, says Anne Wojcicki, also known as Baby Woj, now 44. She had a real fighter mentality growing up, and I feel that was how we were raised. We're all super comfortable in controversy. My mom's like, listen, a lot of really bad stuff happened in my life. You either let that control you or you make the rest of your life great. Her little brother died when she was little. You don't let a bad experience hold you back, otherwise you spend the rest of your life ruined by that experience. So it doesn't matter what happened today. Make it better tomorrow. Wojcicki used that philosophy to claw her way out of her dark hole. It was a bad year, she says, sitting in her small glass office in her uniform of Lululemon shorts and shirt and company-issued jacket. She laughs ruefully.